Crashed it. Oh well. Leaving it in. So this is a demo of the project I've been working on in SuperCollider lately for my class sound design in SuperCollider with Dr. John Thompson. So if you want to find someone to blame for the monstrosity that is this project, you can blame him. This patch basically just takes four tape players into SuperCollider via different inputs that you specify over here. Drag them around, or you type them in. Here I have on this first input a tape loop that I cut. So here I'm gonna press the key command that corresponds with the view that I'm currently focusing on, which is this one. Its key command is number one. So number one on my keyboard starts this synth def at the parameters that I've given it, and the GUI will reflect those parameters. The wet sound mixed in with the dry sound. Here's just the dry sound by itself. Okay, so this knob right here controls how much dry signal is in your synth. It's more of a thing to be layered in this particular instance. The whole idea behind this is to just take a sound that you would normally have in a tape player or on a loop and just kind of destroy it. Okay, so here we have our volume for our wet signal. So this is the amplitude that goes into our Eugen, or it goes into our synthesis definition over here, if you can see my code right here. But so I'm just going to kind of mess around with it and talk about the parameters that I have in this GUI. So I'm just going to turn everything down first. So here we just have our dry signal and our wet pitched signal. So what this is doing is it's taking the signal and it's pitching it away from its original pitch with a ratio. It's granulating it and playing the grains overlapping from each other and spreading them out. These two parameters down here that are also arguments involved in the pitch shift.ar. So you have pitch dispersion. And so that kind of, you can't really hear it here, but when you get higher up with it. You can kind of hear it doing weird things to the pitch in the background. It becomes more apparent when you add this here time dispersion in. And in the help file, it says that these are more or less randomizing around your original pitch and time parameters that you're setting in this here pitch ratio. So you hear some pretty weird things happen when I just do that. This is just a low pass for the wet signal. So we're just filtering the wet signal, filtering all the highs out, and then this. This is just a filter for the dry signal. So if you wanted to add a little bit of dry in, but you didn't want it to be so forward in the mix, these chaos knobs right here, these actually take your P-disp and your T-disp, your pitch dispersion and your time dispersion, and it adds white noise and a low frequency sine oscillator to just a few random but kind of planned out points in the synthesis definition. Plan with these was to kind of make it where I couldn't really understand what was happening at first, so it could be purposefully ambiguous. They really do what they're labeled to do, and they really mess with how stable the sound is. We're already kind of making it destabilized here with these arguments. But when we add in these chaos parameters, you really start to hear a lot of weird things happen to the sound. Starts to get really muddied up because this pitch dispersion is getting shifted wildly, among a lot of other things that I just wanted to randomly permutate based on, you know, a parameter that just made it sound chaotic. And I think that the goal was achieved there. And so, but down here in the post window, you can see that the delay time is being changed. And it's just muddying the signal up even more. Pitch it down there. See if I can try to isolate just the delay. Yeah. So you can hear it kind of cascading behind it. I'm gonna shorten that delay. It sounds higher. It sounds more in your face to me. And then you have your decay time, which, you know, how long the delay takes to go away. And if you get the rate down to a certain point, it kind of sounds like it's starting to oscillate at times. Because you're getting down there to however many milliseconds, which is however many cycles per second. And once you get past 20, it starts to oscillate at the point at which we can hear it. And so here, this chaos messes directly with this pitch shift ratio. So it really makes things sound unstable, especially when the other ones are on. So here's it with no chaos on at all, on any of the knobs. Here's it with just some chaos on it. You don't hear it doing a whole lot. Here's it with the second one on. And here's it with the third one on. And immediately you hear this one. For these two, you kind of have to have these on up here, like I said. Because these kind of directly correlate with these and the reverb. And so you can really start to make things sound really harsh. And I'm going to turn the Willie Nelson tape on now. And I don't know if I highlighted this before, but the key commands are gate on, gate off, are the ones I have set up right now. And all these are shiftable. Oh, and another thing I didn't mention is I also have the ability in here to pitch this around with the MIDI controller. So it'll move the knobs around, respectively. With whatever key I press on this here MIDI controller.
Georgia, 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 no peace I find, just an old.
So I hope you enjoyed my cover of Willie Nelson's cover of Georgia on My Mind. Thanks. At this point, I've been awake for about